बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम अस्सलामुअलैकुम मुल्तान पब्लिक स्कूल एंड कॉलेज मुल्तान। माय नेम इज़ मोहम्मद कासिम कुरैशी। नाउ आई स्टार्ट योर क्लास ओ लेवल 9 चैप्टर नंबर 8 सिक्योरिटी एंड एथिक्स। इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल लर्न अबाउट द कीपिंग डेटा सेफ फ्रॉम एक्सीडेंटल एंड मैलसिव डैमेज, keeping data safe from unauthorized users, computer ethics. Keeping data safe is extremely important for a number of reasons. It may be personal data that you want to keep within your family or your close friends, or commercial data such as passwords and bank account details, which need to be kept safe to protect your money. Data can be corrupted or deleted either through accidental damage or through a malicious act. There are many ways to keep data safe, and some of the methods available will be covered. There is also a security whether a user is working on offline computer or on a computer connected to the internet. Keeping data safe is very important. Data is threatened by malicious software, hackers, or accidental damage. Different security risks and consider the ways to overcome or minimize them. Each security risk together with its description, possible effects and risk migrations will be set out as follows. From your book, page number 97 and figure 8.1, so this is the description of the security risk. Name of the security risk is the two types, possible effects of the security risks, and methods to remove the security risks. Now we discuss one by one these security risks. Hacking. From your book, page number 98, hacking means the act of gaining illegal access to a computer system. This can lead to identify theft or gaining personal information. Data can be deleted, changed, or corrupted. Firewalls, use of the strong passwords and user's ID. Use of anti-hacking softwares. Now we discuss the difference between cracking and hacking. Hacking is breaking into a computer system to real personal data without the owner's consent or knowledge. It means that to steal a password file. Cracking is where sometime edits a program source code, looks for the backdoor in the software so that code can be exploited or changed for a specific purpose. This is usually done for a malicious purpose. For example, send a user to a specific website. Essentially, hacking is not necessary. Harmful, violent cracking is always totally illegal and is potentially very damaging. In short, hacking, the act of gaining illegal access to a computer system. Now we discuss second of security ethics is viruses. This is most important viruses. Everybody knows about this viruses. Now we discuss its definition and its possible effects. Program or program code that can replicate or copy itself with the intention of deleting our corrupted files, or of course the computer to malicious functions. Backing up files would not guard against viruses, since the virus may have already attached itself to the backup files. Using the backup may simply reinstall the virus, can cause the computer to crash, stop functioning normally or become unresponsive, can delete files or data, can corrupt files and data. install for your protection, install antivirus softwares, don't use software from unknown sources. This is most important that don't use software from unknown sources. Be careful when opening emails or attachments from unknown senders. Be careful about this viruses. It's the most damaging of your computer, to damage your computer, your data, and your hard drive. In short, the definition of the virus is that program or program code that itself be intentionally to deleting and corrupting your file and your hardware. Now we discuss the third type is phishing. The definition of the phishing is that the creator sends out a legitimate and locking email as soon as the receptionist clicks on in link in the email attachment. The user is sent to a fake and bogus websites. When you open your bogus websites, this email which is attached to your computer corrupted is also attached to your computer, that large companies such as well-known banks to try to convince customers that the email are authentications. The creator of the email can gain personal data such as bank account numbers from the users when they visit the fake websites. This can lead to fraud or identify the theft. Many IPs, ISPs filter out phishing emails. The user should always be cautious when opening emails or attachments. Farming, this is also four types which will be security threats from you, from your outsiders. Malicious code installed on a user hard drive or on the web server. The code will redirect the user to a fake or bogus websites without their knowledge. The user should look out of the clues that show secure websites such as the padlock signs next to website URLs. The creator of the malicious code can gain personal data such as bank account numbers from users when they visit the fake websites. This can lead to fraud and identify theft. Some anti-spyware software can identify and remove the farming code from the hard drive. The user should always be alert, looking out of the clues that they are being redirected to another website. In short, we will study about the security and threats in this chapter and discuss the mukhtalif different styles, hacking, viruses, phishing and farming. These are the security threats from you, from your data, from the outsiders. So thank you. If you feel some problem, then visit my website. Thanks. Allah Hafiz.